your WLKY weather with Chief Meteorologist Jay Cardosi.
Well, as you know, lots of cold temperatures again across the region by late this afternoon. No big weather changes out there on this last day of February. As a matter of fact, we saw the passing snow flurries this morning, even a little bit of drizzle mixed in. And you know what? That trend could certainly continue as we move on into this evening. If there is some good news to report and you do have some travel plans around the area tonight or tomorrow morning, we're not worried about any icy travel. It's just cold out there. What you see, the gray skies from our live tower cam, that's what you're going to get. Here's the radar scope right now. Zoomed in tight around Metro Louisville, not much being picked up on the radar scope. Same can be said across all of the viewing area. But again, having said that, a chance for a flurry or some spotty drizzle will be with us, certainly as we move throughout the night. 37 degrees across the board, a very popular number in the metro. Feel like temperatures down to 30 with that west to northwest breeze, 10 miles per hour. Of course, it's cloudy out there. It's cloudy all across the Ohio Valley. Look at the numbers, basically 30s. Very, very popular all the way from the lakes down through the Tennessee Valley. And when you factor in the breezes, there's an edge out there. It feels like the 20s to near 30. And of course, that's what you want to dress for if you have the outdoor plans anytime soon. Look at all the clouds. That's that gray on the map. I mean, a large portion of the United States covered up by these low clouds, and from time to time a few snow showers and flurries or a little bit of drizzle. What's going on? We have a huge dip in the jet stream that's covering the eastern one half of the lower 48. The upper level storm system continues to weaken and pull off to the northeast, but still strong enough to produce these clouds and the chances for flurries, a northwest breeze, and a lot of cold air, certainly. Overnight tonight, these are the expected lows with that chance for a couple of flurries or some spotty drizzle. We'll drop very close to freezing from top to bottom all across the viewing area, and we're not going to climb all that much tomorrow. Highs back into the upper 30s. What we are watching, though, on the bigger picture, we have high pressure sprawled out from central Canada down into the central plains, and a little bit farther off to the east, of course, we have the storm system in between that northerly flow pumping in that colder weather. Now, the high will start to build in the next couple of days, but until Saturday, I should say until Sunday afternoon, we're going to hold on to lots of clouds, of course. I think the next chance for some sunshine really won't arrive until the second half of your weekend. So in detail, tomorrow and Saturday, cloudy, cold conditions both days, temperatures in the middle and upper 30s. For Sunday, finally, it looks like we're going to get some sunshine back in here, especially in the afternoon. Not all that warm, upper 30s across the region, but hey, at least we'll have some sunshine. Let's check the forecast in detail now. Next few hours, cloudy and cold, a spotty flurry or a little bit of drizzle, that cannot be ruled out as temperatures will be slowly dropping through the 30s. 35, 10 o'clock tonight, same pattern, a couple of flurries or some drizzle. Waking up to that flurry chance, just like we had this morning, readings around 32. A slow climb to 36 by midday, nothing new there, huh? That afternoon high, 38 degrees, 36 Saturday, 38 Sunday, despite a little bit of sunshine in the afternoon, 43 on Monday. And then Vicky Rick, a new system will move into the region and give us a chance for more rain and snow showers Tuesday into Wednesday morning. Finally, I think we'll break this pattern, but not until next Thursday and also next Friday. You guys were mentioning about Hawaii.
Yeah.
Is this going to hurt? Let me get my sunglasses.
You know what?
Hang on.
You're going to have to wait just a little bit longer. The internet's down right now. I'm trying to get a picture of the beaches for you.
You do that.
We can decide why Hawaii is the happiest place.
Yeah,
you know what? I don't understand why Kentucky was so. Did they do that during basketball? Not basketball, but.
No, they did it in February, I guess.
February?
When it looks like
Billy Gillespie, when Billy Gillespie was coaching, that's when they did the survey during basketball season.
I'll try and get that picture for you, and we'll all be drooling when I get it.
Certain.
All right. Thanks, Jay.